Internet, hello, and welcome back to OKLCS Season 3, Week 3. We're getting into our second series of the night. Of course, it is Gold Cap, the Swasu LOL Club versus Taste Like Purple. Game 1, we just saw the Rock Solid Rift Turtles take down the Full Metal bottom lane 2-0, and we'll be getting into that game in just a few seconds. Just as a quick reminder, I'm Alex, Agent A22, and with me co-casting is, of course, Shaden, the one and only Shaster15 caster.
Yep.
All right, we'll go ahead and jump into that game right now and start us off here. Of course, it is the Swasu LOL Club on the blue side and the Taste Like Purple on the red side. We haven't seen the Swasu LOL Club play yet because they had a bye in week one and we didn't stream Gold Cap last week. But so this will be our first real showing of the Swasu LOL Club. We'll have to see
To see what they can do, honestly. Yeah. I mean, I hope everyone knows this is my first season as a whole being with the Oklahoma LCS. So a lot of these teams I get to see for the first time, and it's really fun getting to see the players.
Mercury is going to face check into a lot of members of Taste Like Purple. He's going to get Shadow Dash. He will fall. No summoners burned on either side, but they will be first blood over to Dark Ages. That's really unfortunate that
Very
the AD carry picks it up.
The Sona was trailing a little bit behind. I think Caitlyn maybe just click to the tri-bush and kind of just let it take its path there. But very unfortunate. But like I was saying, like, I get to see a lot of these teams and players for the very first time, and it's very exciting. And I mean, it's great to cast with someone like Alex who can kill the play-by-plays. And so he gets to make every single player who does something good seem very good. It's very fun to do.
Oh, thanks, man. That's really nice.
No, definitely. Like, even if I was just spectating and watching the Oklahoma LCS like I was last season and the season before, like, it makes it so enjoyable to have someone who can do the play-by-play so fast, know the champion abilities. Not to put pressure on you, but just had to give you a little bit of credit there.
So, the first interesting thing about this game is Lord Anthony's playing this top lane Nautilus, but he's actually gone for the Summoner Ghost as opposed to the Summoner Flash. That's really interesting. We'll have to see if he can show us why that is so.
I mean, I guess to chase down an auto for the root.
I guess so, but you could just do that so much more easily with a flash.
Flash Dredgeline.
Especially with the nerfs to Ghost. But I mean, it is on a shorter cooldown, so we'll see if he can make use of that. He actually started the Ruby Crystal and a Control Ward as well. You can see that Control Ward in the topside river.
Yeah. So I mean, early vision is always good, but like you're probably about to say, sorry to interrupt. He's gonna lack on the sustain probably that the Shen has.
Yeah, I mean, not to mention like the Shen not only has potions, but he also has 3 rejuvenation beads. We've seen this triple rejuvenation bead start from Shen a few times at a high level of play. I don't know what he's gonna do with them, but Ghostland's Fight is taking a lot of damage there. The Summer Exhaust goes down. Ghostland's Fight is still ticking down with the poison, but he will not die. He gets that Aria of Perseverance to get the shield off. Toe Knuckles takes a little bit of damage from Guardian Shinobi.
Twitch is not a champion you want to get rolling early. Kind of like the Ezreal we saw in the last game. He's so strong late game, you don't want to give him an advantage early.
And especially playing Sona, who's one of the squishiest support champions you could possibly play. Of course, in return for a lot of that trait potential you just saw from that Hymn of Valor,
yes.
Shadow Dash onto Lord Anthony. He's going to stand in the Spirit's Refuge to dodge away from any of those auto attacks. Lord Anthony definitely getting the lesser end of these trades up against Ron Weasley.
It hasn't shown the mid lane yet, but it looks pretty even there as well. Both of them using one potion, pretty even in CS.
Panther is going to be recalling out. No, he actually canceled his recall. Looks for something. Both Sejuani and Hecarim junglers that really want to farm really fast and get to those hard power spikes at level 6.
They both have
that Trinity Force.
Yes. Very strong ultimates as well.
Yeah. With champions with... Holy cow, that's some damage onto Quasi. Anyway, but like... With these champions, with these AoE ultimates like Hecarim and Sejuani, You want to use those junglers, definitely tend to put a lot of emphasis bottom lane once they hit six. But here we go. There's a gank on the Lord Vantine. He has no flash. He used the summoner ghost already. He's gonna have the shield. He's gonna be ticking down. He's gonna get flashed on by Ron Weasley, but he's not taken out. Toad Knuckles now getting jumped on by Redwater. He has his flash and ghost still available, but burns neither of them. And actually, Lord Anthony made it out of there. Ron Weasley thought he had the kill with that last auto, but did not, and gives up what could have been another kill for himself.
You know, although he didn't get the kill, it's probably really smart not to continue going. I mean, one dredge line from the Nautilus and a slow could get you killed as well, and a one for one does not give you an advantage, really, even though they have, he does have a 10 CS lead.
Quadzy, interestingly enough, he has a Sapphire Crystal. Oh, hold on, a lot of damage onto Dark Aegis. The shield from Quadzy a little bit too slow to block any of that coming out.
Man, like you said, that Sona damage is outrageous right now.
Dark Aegis gonna back pick up the Vampiric Scepter, gonna probably just to sit on so that he has a little bit of sustain in this lane. Caitlyn, Sona, what are you going to do, you know?
Exactly. I mean, he's already down 24 CS. He's got to do something, like you said, to stay in lane, stay farmed up, get to the late game.
Yeah, and he got first blood. He's down 24 CS. Definitely still gold in favor of Mercury over him.
Caitlyn Sona does not sound like a fun matchup for a short range.
And I mean,
look at
that, the BF sword on that recall compared to the Vampiric Scepter.
He won't have pots, but he has a Sona, so I mean, it's not the biggest thing in the world for the Caitlyn to come back with pots.
Exactly.
It looks like Sona also grabbed a control ward to put in the Tri-Bush. Very good. Orianna 6 here. Not a lot of kill pressure in the mid lane in general.
Yeah, not until we get some jungler intervention.
Yes, definitely so. And like you said, both these junglers are going to farm up and give it a little bit until they start ganking.
Yeah, so, I mean, this is definitely going better for these two junglers than the junglers from the last series. They're, at the very least, ahead of their bottom lanes in terms of experience.
Yes.
So Ghostland's Finest, of course. Yeah, Sona very squishy. Ooh. Gets the exhaust, but the Howling Gale does not come across. A lot of damage on the Dark Aegis actually from Mercury. And now Quadzy forced to go around the backside. Dark Aegis goes invisible with the ambush. And he's going to get that Tempest or Eye of the Storm shield. He actually runs onto the 90 caliber net, or into the Yordle Snaptrap, and there's a Summoner heal, but the exhaust will secure a double kill over to Mercury.
I think like we saw early, the Janna exhausting the Sona, I think her and the Twitch were on different pages right there. I think the Janna probably wanted to keep going and try to get that kill, and Twitch backed off.
Yeah. Just getting zoned away by Mercury. Ron Weasley actually taking a lot of damage there. Panther will take away his own blue buff. That hits him to level 6, so he does have the Glacial Prison available. Redwater still working on his 6. This is very interesting. But yeah, Dark Aegis and Quadzy not respecting Mercury and Ghostland's Finest. Quadzy just walks himself over a Yordle Snaptrap, takes the headshot to the face, and just gets taken down really fast.
With that BF sword, that's a lot of damage early. Now he's got the pickaxe as well, so it's going to be more.
Oh, hold on. There's the Shadow Dash onto Lord Anthony. Panther is here as well. He has the Glacial Prison, but they're just going to back away from each other. There's the Stand United onto Panther. It's actually interrupted by the Death Charge, and Lord Anthony gets the shield. He just walks himself out of there. He did burn his ghost at the very least. But
I mean, we haven't seen the flash hurt him as bad as we maybe thought in these ganks.
Yeah, and
you
he
know?
Had ghost back up for that gank as well, so good on him to have that lower cooldown mobility summoner.
Maybe his thought process is that with the Q he has a gap close or an escape, if he can just speed up and maybe get to them. I don't know, very interesting. Something I have not seen.
Yeah, the more interesting thing to me is the fact that he's built a catalyst as his first item.
Is that going
to
be a rod?
I would really hope not. Yes, Rod of Ages, like, in theory, sounds like it'd be a really good item on a lot. Oh, hold on a second. Shadow Dash onto Lord Anthony, and Panther is coming back for another gank, but Lord Anthony's out of mana. Ron Weasley's starting to actually put down a lot of damage, and there's no ghost available. He gets the Dredge Line out of there. Flash on by Ron Weasley. I think it would have been a lot more valuable to use the Glacial Prison rather than a Flash to try and secure that kill.
Definitely so.
Especially since Swasu is picking up an Infernal Dragon on the backside for that one.
So not an awful trade there. Poor Swasu.
And it is going to be Rod of Ages. Oh goodness, Lord Anthony, please.
I guess he wants to just do a little bit of damage, I guess. I mean, I think a tank, I think their team comp really needed a tank here. Even though, I guess he will get probably decently tanky after that.
Yeah. But you would hope so, but, you know, Rod of Ages, every time you bring one of these new AP tanks into the top lane, like, when Maokai first became a top laner, he was building a lot of Rod of Ages. Mm-hmm. When Nautilus came into the top lane, he built Rod of Ages for just a little bit. Toad Knuckles actually forcing the flash away from Redwater because the Shockwave would have pulled him back into tower and killed him. And that's interesting that Redwater has Flash to begin with. Normally you see these Hecarim take Ghost, but that's beside the point.
Yeah, I was watching Meteos the other day, and he accidentally took Flash while he was playing Hecarim, and he was like, that is the worst feeling ever, playing Hecarim with Flash.
Ron Weasley taking so much damage from Lord Anthony.
He is doing a lot of damage.
The Titan's Wrath Shield is just burning him down. So yeah, in general, the Rod of Ages build dies out very quickly. Hold on, Ron Weasley actually gonna get pulled in by the Dredge Line once again. He Shadow Dashes back onto Lord Anthony.
Despite dying once to a Sedge Gank, he's still being really aggressive.
He's now down about a wave of CS to Ron Weasley. Ron Weasley has actually gone for the Tiamat first, before he builds into that Spectre's Cowl like we see now.
Mm-hmm.
In general, you see the Shen at least finish one of his full defensive items before he even starts
and
to build
then,
that Sheen.
Yep.
Or that Tiamat, rather. But of course, it's not the worst thing in the world to get the Tiamat and sit on it until you can upgrade it into the Titanic Hydra later on. Oh, here we go. Lord Anthony getting ganked again by Panther, but here we go. Redwater's in the mix, too. There's a level 9 onto Lord Anthony. Depth Charge is going to knock out both members of Taste Like Purple, but Lord Anthony going very low. He's not as tanky because he doesn't have the Sunfire KB. Will fall, and there's the Shadow Dash onto Redwater. Redwater does not have the Onslaught of Shadows, but here comes Guardian Shinobi. Toad Knuckles following up the backside. He's going to land the ball onto nobody. There's the Arctic Assault and the Stand United out of Toad Knuckles. Redwater refines in, the Shockwave pulls him back in, he will fall to the Command Dissonance. There's the a lot of damage going down. Ace in the Hole gonna be blocked up by Dark Ages. The Swazu LOL Club lose 2-for-1 in the top lane.
Still very tough for that Twitch.
Here comes Guardian Shinobi. Yeah.
We almost see a 40 CS lead and a kill. Or the Caitlyn here. Well, we see it now.
Yeah, and it just would have been so much better if he had had the Bomby Cinder and the Chain Vest in that situation compared to the makings of the Rod of Ages.
I completely agree.
And especially now, like, it's a whole Flash Four from Ghostland's Finest does not find the auto attack that probably would have executed Dark Ages there. Guardian Shinobi gonna be handed off his blue buff, gonna help him out, stacking onto that Tear of the Goddess.
Yeah, still pretty even in the mid lane. I mean, 12 gold, or 12 CS, not too big of a difference. Well, only 7 now, I guess. 8. Orianna answers with her own blue buff. Quick question about the DJ Sona skin. Why aren't we hearing the music from DJ Sona? From spectating.
You only get to hear it if you're on her team, actually.
Dang, dang. I wanted some music going on.
Alright, so Lord Anthony will be doing a slightly bit more damage with that Rod of Ages build, but at the cost of a lot of tankiness that he's missing out on. We're gonna see that build definitely fall off as the game goes on, and like, It makes you weaker in the early game because you're stacking it. It makes you weaker in the late game because you're not as tanky. There's just very few benefits going for this Rod of Ages.
Especially when
Dark Age is actually going to get jumped on there. The exhaust goes down. Ace in the hole. We'll find him as well. Ghostland's Finest is looking for him. He wants to find the execute, but he turns the wrong direction. But here we go. Redwater's going to barrel right into it. Pick up that kill. And Ron Weasley actually taunts Lord Anthony up under the tower. And he gets creep blocked in for another tower shot, but he will not fall. Alright, Ghostland's Finest having to run himself out from under the tower, but he will make it out. Knuckles taking a little bit of damage. He's gonna get stunned up by that Q, but not enough damage to go down. Howling Gale knocks Mercury into the, up in the air while taking tower damage, but Tower First Blood will go down to the Swasu LOL Club in the bottom lane. Dark Aegis is going for the Blade of the Rune King first item on Twitch. Blade of the Rune King was changed on this patch. And, you know, to be honest with you, I don't know if it's better or worse for AD carries, but we will soon see how effective it is on Twitch.
Yeah, with these, that's something that's difficult to do with the Oakland LCS, because when a new patch comes, you know, midway through the week, right before OKLCS, you don't really get games to practice on it.
Okay, so Lord Anthony's boots of choice are, in fact, the boots of mobility, which makes so little sense.
With the ghost and boots of mobility, I assume he just wants to chase people.
But that doesn't make, that makes so little sense, because the boots of mobility turn off to be less movement speed than regular boots in combat, so it's actually counter synergistic with the ghost. It makes absolutely no sense, especially since he's committed himself to trying to just shove in onto Shen. There's no reason to go for boots of mobility when you could get Ninja Tabi, which are so effective against this Twitch, or the Mercury Treads, which can help you with that tenacity. I hate to say it, but I really just hate Lord Anthony's build this game.
Yeah, definitely. Like you said, I think either one of those boots, Tabi's or Murtrix, would have been very effective.
Dark Aegis unloads with the spray and pray, but he's not going to find it more than one auto attack off. Alright, and then Swasu, LOL Club, and Taste Like Purple dance around this Earth Dragon. They still have Glacial Prison available. That combined with the Shockwave could be devastating, but they already used Spray and Pray, so that's a lot of their team fight damage. It looks like Taste Like Purple will secure the dragon for themselves, but the Swasu Level Club are looking for an engage. They will get all knocked up by the Howling Gale. That's probably going to be it. Swasu Level Club, they used the Onslaught of Shadows, but Redwater flashes in afterwards. That was just a really odd engage from the jungler from the Swasu Level Club. Shockwave finds nobody after the crescendo. Nice Shadow Dash from Ron Weasley. They've already taken out Ghostland's Finest, a nice double stun. Redwater falls down, Arctic Assault onto Mercury. He's gonna slow him up. The Summoner who comes out, Panther, backs away. He's gonna get taken down by Guardian Shinobi's Flash Frost.
Sniped him.
Ron Weasley teleports back up into the top lane after using Stand United into the team fight. They trade one for two in favor of Taste Like Purple.
I think we saw maybe a misclick from the Orianna there. Did you see the shockwave?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it could have been onto the Hecarim, but I think it was maybe just a misclick, and it maybe could have ended with them getting two more kills if it was landing.
Yeah. That was just really poor decision from Redwater. He onslaught her shadows into blindness. He didn't get anyone with the fear. Then he flashed over the wall to try and get into the middle of the team. And then, I assume he flashed in because he thought he had the ball on him, trying to get the ball into the middle of them. But he didn't have the ball on him, he got blown up, Shockwave hit nobody.
Yeah.
And it just ended up very catastrophic. Thankfully, Guardian Shinobi able to pick up a kill back onto Panther, but...
Definitely, so very even, even though it's a 2.2k gold lead here for Swasu.
Oh, no, he's gonna take away his own blue buff. So, Ron Weasley's picked up his Jaurum's Fist. It's gonna stack up some HP for him. Generally, you don't see Shens build into the Titanic Hydra after the Tiamat until you've gotten like two or three
That's
full
exactly
tank
what
items.
I was thinking.
So, I would be very surprised to see him finish that Titanic Hydra before the Spirit Visage comes out, and I would definitely disagree with that decision.
I wonder if he's just nervous about how hard this Nautilus is pushing or something, that he's missing out on farm, but he's not far enough behind that should be a worry.
Yeah.
I think the full tank still is a little better, but it might not be a problem.
Oh, Onslaught of Shadows is just a little bit too far. Does not fear up Ron Weasley. He's actually going to Shadow Dash onto. He's going to get jumped on by a Panther as well. They're going to assault onto him. Nice stun, but there's the Glacial Prison. And the wall does not save him. He actually finds Ron Weasley on the other side as well. Dredgeline is going to pull him back, and now Dark Age is going to jump on by Mercury. He's going to get the Piltover Peacemaker. That's a lot of damage, and just gets an auto attack from Mercury on a killing spree.
Pretty much a solo kill there. I think he would have cleaned it up. Even without the Sona there. Even though the Orianna missed her ultimate again, they still got the kill onto the Hecarim. Mm-hmm. Still 3-0-2 from the Orianna, very strong. Might be building into Azania's next. Is that what that looks like?
It looks like it will be Azania. And another tower goes down in favor of the Swasu LOL Club in the bottom lane. That's two towers for none in the bottom lane. Oh, a nice taunt on the Guardian Shinobi, who's
nice.
Tanking up the tower. He still has Egg up available. He's going to not quite get the stun up. Lord Anthony tanking up the tower, but they don't have enough damage to take down Ron Weasley just yet. He's actually taking a lot of damage there. Oh, the Leandria's Torment not going to be enough thanks to the passive shield. Lord Anthony is now going for what I can only assume is a Warmogs, which means that he has a whole lot of health, no resistances, no CDR.
This is such an odd build. I don't know if I've seen something like this on a Nautilus, but hey, we'll see how it plays out. Rotation in the top lane.
But you've got Guardian Shinobi here on this Anivia. Yes. He's going to be able to clear out the wave like no problem whatsoever.
So that rotation ended up working very well. It looks like an easy top turret there.
Swasu LOL Club, 4 towers to 0, find themselves 4.1k gold in the lead. So Dark Aegis has the Blade of the Rune King and the Berserker's Greaves, but Mercury has Infinity Edge, Berserker's Greaves, and almost has his Runon's Hurricane, just waiting to combine those two items into it.
Yeah, that Caitlyn's going to be doing a ton of damage. Yeah, I know we keep bringing it up, and it probably gets old for the viewers, but I wish we had a tank Nautilus there to be the big front line for this Anivia and Caitlyn to sit behind.
Yeah.
Maybe just have a Sona with the ultimate and do a little poke damage, use the ultimate.
Yeah, at the very least, in compensation, Redwater is not even building the Trinity Force. He's going for a full tank Hecarim build, which
I don't mind that at all. Yeah. I mean, I wish I maybe still see the Triforce, but with the damage Nautilus build, it might definitely be necessary.
It's just like, you miss out on so much when you don't have that Trinity Force on Hecarim. Mm-hmm. You're missing out on a lot of CDR that you would have gotten from that item. And so, it's just suboptimal that he's gone for this full tank build in order to compensate for Lord Anthony's...
That is a lot of damage coming from that Caitlyn on that crit.
Swasu LOL Club, they're hanging around here. Have to be careful of the Stained United available from Ron Weasley should the members of Taste Like Purple go for an engage here. Ghostland's Finest Moose Sword aggressively just drops some damage with that Hymn of Valor. Taste Like Purple. Ooh, Quanzi down to about half. Throwing out those Howling Gales.
I'd be nervous for a Flash Ultimate here from the Sona onto the Twitch and Orianna.
They're just continuing to throw down damage. Uh-oh, Flash 4! Onslaught of Shadows pushes Quanzi into the enemy team and Taste Like Purple loses no support. A nice crescendo, and the wall comes in to stop force Taste Like Purple away. Swasu LOL Club pick up Quanzi for basically nothing. Ron Weasley, Stand United was cancelled by Lord Anthony. They're trading back and forth here.
That was a great ultimate coming from that Sejuani. There would have been two more deaths.
Yeah, absolutely.
For Taste Like Purple, but very good ultimate there. One death and a dragon, not the worst thing in the world. They were just battling it out in this top lane.
Anther's now here in the top lane as well, but he was spotted out by a minion. He did not sneak his way nicely into that brush.
Lord Anthony still has both of his summoners, Ghost and Teleport. I don't even know, besides teleporting to lane, has he used it for anything else yet?
I don't think he's used Teleport to get to any fights, no.
Not a big deal yet. I mean, he's got the first turret.
Yeah, he's doing a good job, like, where he needs to be on the map, and he's interrupting Stand United's appropriately. Toe Knuckles handed off his blue buff. Yeah, the Nautilus has no resistances in his build right now. Oh. He's got nothing but health and then boots of mobility, which make so little sense to me still.
Looks like Tastes Like Purple might be looking for a pick here.
Gale's just gonna disengage. Uh-oh. Oh, Dredgeline onto Quanzi. He's taking a lot of damage. There's the monsoon to disengage the fight, but he gets the depth charge onto him. Nice wall to zone off the members of Tastes Like Purple. Panther comes in to be the front line, but no follow-up engage. Tastes Like Purple forced away from their own jungle, but here's a lot of members of Slossu. He's unloading with the spray and pray, but Dark Age is not able to unload nicely and safely. They're looking for it. Here's the Onslaught of Shadows. Redwater gets in near the members of Tastes Like Purple. Panther, Arcane Assault his way out of there. Nice crescendo onto two members of Tastes Like Purple, but countered by the nice shockwave off of the Glacial Prison, but not enough damage. Slossu, LOL Club are still all alive. Shadow Dash onto two members of Tastes Like Purple. Ron Weasley into the front, and Redwater is slowly falling, but he's actually still pretty healthy. Ron Weasley gets pulled back, and Shadow Dash is back over the side. Nobody dies except for Dark Ages. They lost the egg from Guardian Shinobi.
Oh my gosh. How did the Shin get out? And I mean, how did Swasu get out of that Orianna ultimate? I mean, great shockwave come out right there. It's not enough damage.
Yeah, Dark Ages is so behind, and when you have this, when you have a Twitch who's behind and an Orianna who has already blown her entire load, there's not any more follow-up damage to come out. Dark Aegis was just not able... He unloaded with Spray and Pray a little bit too early when the members of Swasu LOL Club were not crowd-controlled, so he only got really, like, two autos off that were AoE, and then fell really fast, so... Probably should have held onto the Spray and Pray, stayed safe until they got that Glacial Prison Shockwave combo, and then he probably could have picked up like 3 or 4 kills in that fight.
Definitely so.
Both mid laners are 3-0 at this point, both of them playing pretty well. I actually do very much like the Liandry's Torment early onto Guardian Shinobi's and Nivea. In general, you see probably like 2 mana items on the Nivea. I'm surprised that he hasn't gone for either the Rod of Ages or the Morella Namakon. But he is getting a little bit of an earlier spike going for the Liandry's Torment second.
Definitely.
So.
This Twitch is still down a ton of CS.
Yeah,
it's gonna be...
Dark Ages is in a big hole, despite getting first blood.
Very big hole. Especially since he's gonna have this Hecarim and Nautilus jumping onto him. I guess they do have the Janna to get one of them or both of them off of him, but...
It's still gonna be really hard for him to find a good place to spray and pray. I'm easily getting jumped on by Lord Anthony here. They're not taking each other down particularly quickly. Ron Weasley with the secret agent 007.
Yep, definitely.
Yeah, they're trading onto each other, but the members of the Swasu LOL Club are the ones who are collapsing into the top lane. It looks like they're sending them back into the mid lane to try and hold off on that one. Alright, so Mercury X has finished his double crit items, the Infinity Edge and the Runons, but then, Flash burned. But then he's going for a Blade of the Rune King, which is Really interesting. It's not something you normally build on Caitlyn just because you want more raw AD for crits and headshots. I guess in theory it's good to build up against these health stacking tanks. The Swashbuckler Oak Club actually starting off on this Baron. I don't know if they do find it. They see it with a ward. Oh, but Lord Anthony gonna try and root up Panther so we can't get in. It will be secured by a nice smite for Red Water. And Dark Aegis unloading with a spray break. He's actually getting a good one off, but he doesn't have the damage. He goes down. Guardian Shinobi picks him up. Shockwave finds a lot of members of the Swasu LOL Club, but Mercury is free autoing. Panther smites him to run himself away, but he will find the ace, and the hole will not die to it thanks to the Eye of the Storm Shield. They trade one for two, but Baron over to the Swasu LOL Club.
Yeah, I think kind of just like we said, that Twitch so far behind honestly should have been able to kill that Caitlyn in that position that he was in. And then Hecarim jumped onto him and there was just no getting away.
Yeah.
Immediately deleted.
Oh, nice stretch line onto Panther. Panther has to back away, but here comes the teleport in from Ron Weasley. Lord Anthony now getting jumped on by a lot of members of Taste Like Purple, but here comes Mercury and Redwater. They're actually going to run away. Mercury gets Flash Shadow Dash onto Ren Weasley, now auto-attacking him down. He will fall to the dragon, actually. Toe Knuckles put down some damage, and then the dragon executed the AD carry of Swasu LOL Club. Ron Weasley now chasing down onto Lord Anthony. They back away from each other as Panther comes back to try and secure this dragon. He actually smites it early. It will finally go down. Yeah, so the Blade of the Rune King, I guess I kind of understand his rationale behind this, since there's a lot of health stacking, Shen and Sejuani. But in that case, I think that the Lord Dominique's Regards would just be a lot better than the Blade of the Rune King for a Caitlyn.
At least just the Last Whisper part of it, maybe, and then going into another item.
Yeah. I can't say I really like Blade of the Rune King on Caitlyn either.
It's just something I'm very unfamiliar with. I haven't seen that, you know? So I guess I can't knock it until I try it or see it in action.
Right, so we have Swasu LOL Club still have the Baron for just a little bit more. Mercury gonna take away his red buff, as will Dark Aegis. I'm curious about the Blade of the Rune King on Twitch. It's definitely makes a lot more sense on Twitch than it does on Caitlyn.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe would he have been better going just for like Infinity Edge into another crit item? I don't know.
I guess we'll find out.
Dead Man's Plate now finished for Lord Anthony. I mean, at the very least, it's some resistance, you know, but
it just makes me wonder what he's going to go next. Is it worth...
I think that that armor item should have been a Randuin's Omen against the Twitch.
With the Twitch, yes. I completely agree. What do you think about it? Normally, I would think I would see a Guardian Angel here at this point in the game, but with the Rod of Ages, Warmogs, and Dead Man's...
Yeah, you need
would you
to...
see it?
I mean, I guess it makes sense because it's double resistances to go with all that health stacking he's got, so
yes. Yeah,
that would have not been a bad idea, Guardian Angel. Yeah, but like, the Randuin's applies to Twitch even if he autos through you, so the Randuin's definitely would something that to consider to build for either Redwater or Lanar, Lord Anthony. At least Redwater has picked up the Frozen Heart for himself.
Yeah, he's getting very tanky
Ooh,
honestly, himself. He's
taking a lot of damage there. Well, okay, some damage.
I thought it was going to be a lot more. We'll go with that, you know?
He's building into that Sunfire Cape third item. He probably should have finished that before finishing his Titanic Hydra. Actually, definitely should have finished that before finishing his Titanic Hydra. Lord Anthony and Ron Weasley going to be trading on Twitter. Dredgeline finds Quatsy. He's actually rooted up now. He gets jumped on by Redwater. The Monsoon to disengage the fight. Death Charge is going to go down. Knock them both up. Nice shockwave into the Glacial Prison. Now Dark Aegis is trying to unload with the Spray and Pray, but he falls because he gets stunned up under the Glacial Storm. Ron Weasley now getting jumped on, and Mercury will fall on a Panther. Now Panther is in the middle of four members of the Swasu LOL Club, but he gets the Stand United and falls anyway. Double kill over to Guardian Shinobi. They trade 3-for-1 in favor of the Swasu LOL Club. Redemption comes down just topped them all off. And Dredgeline finds Toe Knuckles. He's going to take a lot of damage. Lord Anthony happy to tank this one up. He's not quite as tanky as you'd expect, but he's tanky enough to tank the tower. The Zhonya's and the Flash will keep Toe Knuckles alive, but the Slusu LOL Club will definitely will be securing the first inhibitor of the game.
Yeah, we saw another fight where a very good Orianna ult comes out, but they still don't win the fight. I mean, Twitch immediately got deleted once someone got onto him again. Yeah. And
it's just such an unfortunate game for Dark Ages.
Yes, the problem right there was the Nautilus grabbed the Janna immediately in the fight, so Twitch really didn't have any peel whatsoever there.
Yeah, the Monsoon and the Howling Gale were forced to be used for Quadzi's benefit alone, and Dark Ages just got blown up, was not able to get into auto where the Shockwave had pulled everyone in.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, goodness. What is he building now? Lord Anthony's picked up the Ruby Crystal and the Sapphire Crystal. I can only assume that that's another Catalyst item, which I would assume is a Righteous Glory, which means even more health with no resistances, which is just really inefficient. Build some resistance items like Sunfire Cape and Spirit Business.
Maybe he just thinks that the Twitch is going to get deleted so early or something that the Orianna alone can't take him down with all that health.
That's at least reasonable rationale there.
That's what I'm trying to help him out. I'm trying. With a build like that, it's tough, though. It's tough.
The Rabadon's is finished off for Guardian Shinobi as well. He's doing so much damage. 6-1 and 0.
Yeah, and I mean, the Orianna's going to be packing some damage as well now. Maybe going with the Luden's Echo next?
The thing is, the Orianna is doing well. She's 4-0-5, but she's gone for Morello into Zhonya's. Mm-hmm. Finally now finishes off the Rabadon's, which will be some damage, but Morello into Zhonya's is a very low damage build. Two-item spike. You don't do very much damage with two items compared to if you've gone Luden's Echo or Rabadon's Death Cup second. Oh, Panther actually, our biggest hold forward. He's going to go Glacial Prison on Guardian Shinobi and Ghost and Swine. Shockwave flashed away from both members. Though Spray and Pray is coming out, but he's jumped on. Is Quadzi and Guardian Shinobi fighting it out? Panther is going to get onto him. The Redemption keeps him alive, and now Panther is in trouble. He will fall double kill over to Guardian Shinobi. Ron Weasley in the backline. He's going to Shadow Dash his way out of there. Ace in the hole onto Dark Aegis, who will just fall over Mercury. Free autoing onto the members of the Taste Like Purple, while Lord Anthony by himself in the top lane.
It looks like he's easily going to get this top lane turret. I mean, no one there to contest.
Yeah, the Swasu LOL Club win a 4v5 because they just kite back so effectively. Taste Like Purple use all of their abilities when they aren't in range.
That might be 3 inhibs.
Yeah, that's the second inhib definitely going down in the bottom lane, and then you have a big wave being escorted in by Lord Anthony.
It looks like Taste Like Purple will be up fast enough to stop this.
Depends on how fast Mercury gets there.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
Mercury rotating around, just trying to be as safe as possible. The inhib does go down, or the inhib tower goes down, but the inhib will stay alive.
We could see them move to Baron. I mean, they've already taken one.
And Quadzi has Quadzi's trying to help out Dark Ages with that Zeke's Harbinger, mm-hmm. trying to give him some extra crit, but that means that he doesn't have a redemption. He doesn't have a locket. There's no locket or redemption on the side of Taste Like Purple. Whereas
this makes Anivia so much stronger.
Yeah. I mean, with Ghostland's Finest, he has both of them available to him.
Mm-hmm.
And those item axes are just so powerful. You don't realize how good they are. Swasu LOL Club will secure themselves a free Baron. No contest from the side of Taste Like Purple. And it's just going to be an easy push into the top lane to pick up that inhib. Ron Weasley and Lord Anthony find each other in the jungle. He's actually surrounded by Taste Like Purple now, but they're actually not doing a whole lot of damage. This is the tank and the support. And now here we go, flash in from Onslaught of Shadows from Redwater, but they're all in their base. Ghostland's Finest is actually taking a lot of damage. Nice crescendo onto 4! And there's the Death Charge onto Dark Aegis. Dark Aegis is in a bad spot once again. Gets taken down. Man. Swasu LOL Club lose. Pick up 3 kills. The Redemption gonna top them all off as they go to end the game.
Not a fun matchup for a Twitch in general. I mean, even getting that first blood, though, he's still going against a Caitlyn Sona in lane, has a Hecarim going after him in every fight, and let alone a Nautilus.
Yeah, so Celestial Elo Club find themselves 1-0 in the series.
It's going to be really interesting to see what Tastes Like Purple comes back with in the next game. I mean,
definitely need to make some adjustments if they want to stay in this series.
I really like that Swasu went for the aggressive bot lane, and then the slow building of Nivy, which not actually slow with the Liandry's there. I mean,
yeah, like they had so much pressure in the bottom lane. They actually even had pressure in the top lane.
Yes.
And of course, Hecarim just so obviously Hecarim is considered a much better jungler than Sejuani. Sejuani's really just an ultimate, has no pressure in the early game, has literally can only do one thing in later fights. I mean, she did them well, she landed some good ones, but they were so behind by that point that the Shockwave didn't do enough damage, the Twitch did no damage.
Yeah, the only damage they had in the game was the Orianna, and that's not going to be enough.
Especially with the Morello into Zhonya's build. Just having to build more safely to try and survive meant that they're sacrificing so much damage. Anyways, that is game one. We'll come back with game two in just a few minutes. We'll see if Taste Like Purple can make the comeback in the series, or if Swasu LOL Club will close it out. See you in just a few minutes.